In a simple enough game, you can learn and use all the actions available to you very quickly. If there are few enough possibilities, you can use your entire moveset right from the beginning. This doesn't mean a game with a limited moveset's easy, but it means that you can remember and utilize all your tools at your disposal almost immediately. In fighting games, each character usually has a lot of moves compared with almost any other genre. Let's look at what a character has in Street Fighter V.
Any given character will have 6 standing attacks, standing light, medium, and heavy punch, along with standing light, medium, and heavy kick.
6 crouching attacks, performed by pressing any of those same 6 attack buttons while holding down. At least 6 different jumping attacks, performed by pressing any of those same 6 attack buttons during a jump.
Every character will also have a bunch of special moves. For each move, the properties will vary depending on whether you press the light, medium, or heavy punch or kick button.
You'll have a few command normals, which are attacks done by pressing a direction and an attack button at the same time. So we're kind of running out of room on the screen, and we haven't even addressed universal movement options, throws, chain combos, different things you'd use the meters on the bottom of the screen for. So all told, any given character is going to have 40 or 50 different things they could be doing at any time, which is an impossible number of things to keep in mind. So with so many options available to you, how do you know where to even start? Many moves are situational, while others may be very strong and generally useful. The key is to find those few strong core moves and form a game plan around them. This is not just true for Street Fighter V, but for any fighting game you're ever going to try to pick up. For example, when I first started playing the beta for Street Fighter V, I was playing mostly Chun-Li, so what I did at first was find a good move for controlling horizontal space on the ground, and then find a good move to anti-air jumping opponents, and that was kind of it. So with that kind of idea in mind of keeping things as simple as possible, let's try to work out a plan for Chun-Li right now. First, we'll use Stand Heavy Punch. This move is pretty quick, does pretty good damage, and has good reach, so I'll try to use this to control the ground. For anti-airing opponents, I'll use Back Heavy Kick. It's a pretty reliable anti-air that does pretty decent damage. I'll also use Throw, done by pressing the 2 light attacks together. So I'll just use this when the opponent is scared or just sitting there and blocking and not doing a whole lot. I'll use the universal movement option of just walking backward and forward. This'll let me adjust my spacing without taking big risks to do so. I'll use dashing forward and backward. So this is faster than walking, but riskier since you can't really do anything until the dash completes. But for situations where I need to move quickly, I can use this option. Finally, I'll use Crouch Medium Punch. I'll use this against opponents who throw projectiles, as it can go underneath them, and if I space it right, I can actually hit the opponent. And that's it. That's literally everything. So, with so few moves, my strategy will be really, really simple, which is good. The exact number is under debate, but human working memory can hold around 3 to 5 chunks of information, so we should try to stay within that limit. When my opponent is on the ground, I'll walk or dash to get in range for Stand Heavy Punch. Once I'm in range, I'll just try to hit them with it. If my opponent jumps at me, I'll anti-air them with Back Heavy Kick. When my opponent seems reluctant to press a button of their own, I'll walk or dash forward and try and throw them. And if my opponent's throwing fireballs, I'll try to go underneath them with Crouching Medium Punch to avoid the fireball and maybe get some damage. By deliberately starting with a very small pool of moves, I'm ensuring a few things. 1, I'm not mashing, but making deliberate decisions about which moves to use and when. 2, I'm internalizing when using these moves is a good or bad idea. And because I'm using these moves a lot, I'm seeing whether they're effective in a ton of different situations in every single match I play. 3, I'm internalizing these moves and their properties and moving that information from my short-term memory, which is limited capacity, kind of temporary data storage, to my long-term memory, which is functionally limitless. And 4, I have a plan and I'm sticking to the plan. This is maybe the most important point. Having a plan means you have a path to improvement. This is because you can analyze what worked and what didn't work, and then change the plan going forward based on what you've learned and have a better chance for success. The idea is that you start with a base strategy. You're using a very small number of moves, so it's easy to keep them all in mind at once. Because you're using a small number of moves, you can learn about situations where they succeed and fail and really get to know the moves. Ideally, you picked out moves that are universally useful and they'll form the backbone of your game plan going forward. In part 2 of this series, we'll take a look at how far you can actually get using this strategy and what to do once it stops working as well as it used to as you climb the ranks and face stronger opponents. That's it for part 1. This video is just one person's opinion on how to approach fighting games, but I hope at least somebody out there finds it helpful. If you like the video and want to find out more or support me, here's how you do that. See you next time.